never made like a hair care video, at least not in a long time if I did. So I thought this would be a perfect opportunity to share with you guys my products that I use, how I grow my hair to be literally this long, and also how I style my hair. So if you're interested in that, keep on watching, and without further ado, let's get right on into the video. So a little bit about my hair. It is more on the oily side, and I typically wash my hair around every 2 to 3 days. I've heard a lot of things about training your hair to not be that greasy and to only wash your hair once or twice a week, so that might be something that I might try later on in the future. When I was younger, I had really blonde hair, and as I got older, my hair just got darker and darker, and I've always had a little bit of red in my hair. Would just describe it as like a light brown, strawberry light brown hair. I don't know how to really describe it. Help me in the comments. But this is my natural hair color now. Never dyed it or anything, so I guess that would be one of the things that I've did to keep my hair healthy, is I never dyed my hair. My hair is more on like the wavy, frizzy side, so I probably should have like oils and actual hair care products to help solve that. But I just air dry my hair. I rarely use heat unless I'm like going out somewhere and I'll like straighten my hair or like curl it. But that's a little brief overview about my hair and what I do to it. My go-to shampoo and conditioner is from Kirkland, and I believe it's their moisturizing shampoo and conditioner. I guess it's just the same as Pureology, which is super expensive, and this is like literally a fraction of the price. So if you have a Costco near you, definitely look into it, check it out, try it out. Because for me, it makes my scalp really moisturized, it makes my hair feel really smooth. But I do tend to have like dandruff in my hair sometimes, especially like in the winter months, so I will use like a Head and Shoulders shampoo if I notice I'm gaining a lot of like dandruff or flakiness. And sometimes for my shampoo, I kind of feel a little bit of buildup, so that Head and Shoulders also helps just breaking everything down. And then like every 2 weeks I do an apple cider vinegar wash. So basically it's just apple cider vinegar, it's like 2 tablespoons and then 2 cups of water. You mix it up and you rinse your hair, and oh my gosh, it literally works wonders. It helps with buildup, it smooths your hair. I just do it very, very rarely, like every 2 weeks or so. And then because I have the brassiness in my hair, I use a purple shampoo and conditioner. So actually Amika sent me a whole line of their new formula of the Bust Your Brass collection. So thank you so much for Amika for sending me these products. This is their new formula of the Bust Your Brass collection. If you guys know Amika, they're like a really nice hair care brand. They sent me the shampoo, conditioner, and the hair mask. This is actually for cool blonde, and I have brown hair, so for me it just helps get rid of the brass and like the red in my hair. But all you really do is you just use this as a normal shampoo and conditioner. If you feel like your hair needs a little bit more of a brass control, this is their mask. It is so nice. I've already used it a couple times. It smells amazing. I feel like Amika has like a signature scent because everything smells the same, literally. The hair mask is really, really nice. You just put this on damp hair and you just leave it on for just a few minutes, less than 10 minutes, and then you rinse it out. And I genuinely really like it. I have noticed a difference in, especially up in my scalp. That's kind of where the most like red is, and just using the shampoo just helps get it all out. So it is available at Sephora. I'll put a link to the whole collection down below. Thank you so much again for Amika for sending me these products. I genuinely use these products. I really like them, and I'm so glad I'm working with them in my hair care routine video. So I use the Bust Your Brass collection about 1 to 2 times a week. I don't want to do this so much where it like completely strips a lot of color out of my hair, especially because this is cool blonde and I'm more of a brown, and I just don't know how that's gonna react, so I just stick with like once or twice a week, and that's good for me. So speaking of Amika, I also use their Intense Shine Mask. I promoted that on my Instagram and I still use it to this day. Now that mask is literally, That mask helps make your hair really shiny, and I posted the Instagram photo and my hair looked so healthy and so shiny. I give all the credit to that specific mask. I'll put that in the description down below, but I literally notice a difference in how smooth my hair is. So in the shower, I put this mask from like root to tip. I'll just massage it into my hair and I'll leave it on for about like 2 to 5 minutes and then rinse it out. And while I'm rinsing my hair is just so smooth and feels so silky and so soft. And I genuinely like that product a lot. And because of that, I've grown into a huge fan of Amika. Okay, for styling, I honestly rarely use heat. Whenever I'm going out, I will use heat on my hair, like either straighten it, or even when I'm like filming or vlogging, I'll do my hair a little bit nicer. So obviously my hair is straight. This is not my natural hair at all. It's actually more poofy and like wavy and frizzy. It's not always the best look. Sometimes it actually looks really good air dry, and sometimes it just doesn't. And the difference between my natural hair and when I straighten it is literally insane.
Look at the difference between like putting a few minutes and straightening my hair versus if I left it air dried and just its own thing.
So odds are I would just straighten my hair, because then a couple days later it starts to get a little bit wavy again, and I'm not the best at curling my hair. I just take my curling iron and literally just wrap it around the barrel, and that's pretty much it, and then just straighten the ends. I've actually had my straightener and my curling iron for literal years, so I don't even know what it's called because the label is like rubbed off. And then another way that I avoid using heat in my hair is I will typically take night showers. I will literally put my hair in 2 braids and just sleep on it overnight. Wake up, take the braids out, and then I'm good to go. And my hair tends to not get so frizzy when I put them in braids overnight, versus if I just go to bed with wet hair, I'll wake up and my hair will literally be a mess. So, highly recommend that. Tips to grow my hair. So honestly, I don't have like a certain technique. Like I don't have vitamins I take. I don't have certain products that I use to grow my hair, like oils or whatever. I've always had my hair grow really fast. I will literally put a picture on the screen of my hair literally a year ago and now. Like it's literally so long right now. And then I'll also throw up a picture of when my hair is shorter. So actually comment down below if you like my hair shorter or longer, because I'm going through a dilemma right now. I love them both just as the same, but I'm kind of wanting my short hair back, but I also want to keep my long hair. I don't know. Comments below. So though I don't take vitamins or oils or anything, I do have my Vital Proteins collagen in my coffee, and I know that helps with like hair, skin, and nails. So I included that in one of my tips just because I do drink it on the regular. It's unflavored, so like you don't have to have your coffee taste gross just for your hair to grow. But I definitely recommend Vital Proteins. That's another brand that I'm like all for. I'll put a link to that down in the description below as well. Another major tip that I feel like has helped grow my hair is obviously not using a lot of heat. As I've mentioned before, I don't really do a lot of straightening or curling like on the regular, and I don't dye my hair and never have, so I feel like that's a contributing factor for my hair to grow faster. And that is pretty much my hair care routine, what I use to grow my hair, and my styling tips. I know it's probably not a lie, but you can find better videos out on YouTube, but this is just what I do. This is my routine. This is what I use. So I hope this brought some kind of insight for you guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. I upload every Friday at noon Pacific, and hopefully I will come out with a new vlog soon. I know I've been doing a bunch of like sit down talking videos, and those have been really fun to make, not gonna lie, but I'm just really missing my vlogs. So with that, I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'll see you guys in my next video next week. Bye!